registered. In the instant case, comma, the petitioner continued to hold over up till 31-10-2007, when the petitioner was given a notice to give vacant position after the period of 1 month para. Learned counsel for the petitioner has argued that the notice to terminate was not a valid notice terminating the tenancy and has cited decisions to the effect that unless the language of the notice clearly explicitates that the tenancy itself be terminated, it would not amount to notice of the termination. However, such a plea could be taken only when there was a valid tenancy, not in a case where the petitioner was continued by way of holding over para. Moreover, under clause 9 of the agreement, a notice was to be given by the respondent. Even if the notice was not happily worded, the intention of the notice was to give to the petitioner a 1 month notice to vacate the premises. Stop. The clumsy drafting of the notice would not render the notice either illegal or invalid para. Insofar as the question of settled position is concerned, I am not inclined to agree with the arguments as advanced by the learned counsel for the petitioner in the facts and circumstances of the case, because here the petitioner was seeking to take advantage of by holding over. The true owner had resorted to give a legal notice to terminate the holding over, thereby bringing a legal end to the holding over. The so-called settled position as claimed by the petitioner was brought to an end by the issuance of a valid notice to terminate the so-called tenancy. It could not have been claimed thereafter against a true owner. Para. The court below, while examining three ingredients that are required for the grant of ad interim injunction, also came to the conclusion after examining the facts and circumstances of the case that the petitioner was not able to make out any ground for the grant of ad interim injunction. Para. I am not in agreement with the arguments as made by the learned counsel for the petitioner that the trial court or the appellate court has failed to examine the basic ingredients for the grant of ad interim injunction. Insofar as the prima facie case is concerned, it is abundantly clear that the lease, on the strength of which the petitioner had entered as a tenant, had expired. The petitioner was continuing simply by holding over. Insofar as the bail balance of convenience is concerned, the balance was in favor of the respondents, who is the organization which encourages the entrepreneurs to set up more and more new research projects. Stop. Their intention by leasing out the premises to the petitioner was not to aid to set up his commercial and manufacturing unit. Stop. Moreover, the public at large, which is desirous to set up the research projects, is prevented from getting the new units established if the petitioner is allowed to hold over the premises in dispute is commercial entrepreneurs. Stop. The very purpose of giving the said was not to set up a manufacturing unit for commercial use by the petitioner, but to encourage the new entrepreneur, such the petitioner, for research projects for development of scientific pursuits. Para. Lastly, insofar as the irreparable injury is concerned, the petitioner is simply a manufacturing unit and is individual, whereas the public at large benefits if new research projects are set up. No doubt the petitioner was having a manufacturing unit which employed a few people, but when the entire purpose of respondent Sirdo is to encourage research and development work by the new entrepreneurs, it would be in the larger interest, and that is much greater than the individual's interest, like the petitioner. Para. Thus, in my opinion, that both the courts below have committed no error in coming to the conclusion that the petitioner failed to make out a case for grant of injunction. Para. This writ petition is dismissed as above. The observation made by this court is only with regard to the grant of ad interim injunction and shall not prejudice the case of the petitioner arising out of the suit to be decided by the court below. Stop.